Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design Channel. This channel is about sharing Rhino 3D knowledge to students and professionals learning various Rhino 3D techniques. I have a YouTube subscriber ask me how to design and model the flower petal and has the cutout through it to make it really three-dimensional look. So I would like to use this opportunity to show you this trick and tips. Are you ready? Let's get started. The focus on this tutorial is for the flower petal. So if you're interested in how to make this prong setting, you can go to the video that I'll put a link below, and also how to build a diamond. I also have two videos to talk about that. So we don't have to spend the time talk about the things we already talked, and we can be more focused on the model technique. All right. So let's go to the top view. Let's say I already have this design here, and it's like a cluster setting, cluster arrangement here. And I do want to have my petal, you know, somewhere designed in this quadrant area. So what I like to do is kind of a draw a design area. And in this case, I would like to go to a grid snap and snap there. All right. I don't want it to blocking my view. So I'm going to actually work on other layers and then turn the stone off. I'm going to fill it the curve a little bit. In this case, this is the tip. I may want the radius for 1.5 going from here to here. So I have a little corner there, and the second one, it should be larger. I will set it for 3, and let's go from here to here. This one too on this side, and very last one. It actually doesn't matter that much on the last one, but I'm just gonna go ahead to do 1.5 as well. So that's the shape of my petal. Okay, the second things I wanted to do is I'm going to draw a straight line coming here to here, anything like longer than my design area. And then within that, I'm going to use the array tool, and we're gonna use the polar array. So let me go into make the center to the 0, and number I will set it to 6. And instead of 360 degree like we usually do, I would like to do 90 degrees. So you see all those lines there, okay? The next step that I'm going to do is each of them, I need to rebuild them. So I'm going to pick up all of them, and then I wanna rebuild all of them at once. At this scenario, we want a point count to be 5 and degree to be 3, and then we click OK. All right. So this is what you see there now. Instead of a 2 point, you got 5 point. So the way it's going to work is I'm going to turn on control point on all of them, not a flower design area. I want to turn on the control point. So F10, or you can use the point on. Okay, so I'm going to pick up this one, holding the shift, pick up this one and this one. Okay, and let's take a look on the perspective, might be easier. So with all the point that I just pick it, I'm have them going up a little bit. Okay, and then the next point right there, this one and every other one, I want it to go just down a little bit. All right. Now on the opposite one, which is this one, and this one, let me turn on the control point again. This one for this point, and this point, it was going up on the neighbor. So we want it going down a little bit. And now this one, and this one, we want to go up. So it's kind of giving the opposite direction, and that will give our flower petal a small dramatic look. All right. So next, what I like to do is I'm going to use the loft tool. Under the surface, you have this loft, and then we're gonna loft from U to U to to you, to you, to you, and to the very last one. Okay, so very quickly, you see I have some sort of like up and down on my pedal. If you feel like, okay, so let's go back one more time. If you record a history, and then you go into loft, and you go from 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 5, and 6, then nothing changed. But what happened is, let's say you don't want so symmetrical, and you want to turn on the control point, and want to have this one actually go up a little bit, and then so you can see that form will follow. So you can give in a lot more definition there. Okay, all right, so this is what I have on the top view, and I'm going to pick up my curve, and with this curve, I'm going to trim this guy there, and also that little surface there. So now we have a pedal, and it has a very nice surface right there for us to develop. Okay, so the next step I'm going to do is going to create UV curve, is living under the curve, and you have curve from the object, and then you have create UV curve. Okay, it will give us the curve like this. Now, what does this mean is if this surface being stretched out completely, then it will create in this flat area. Okay, so this is what we get here. Now we can go ahead to design anything that we like, but I want to give in a boulder first. So let me offset this guy for about 1.2 millimeter. So then I got this area. And now we can start doing the free design. I'm just gonna simply to draw a few lines here, for example, and having something like this. Okay, and with this design, we need to giving them some sort of a width as well. So I'm going to offset again, and this time I want to offset both sides. So each side is going to be 0.6 millimeter, and then I want to make sure it's on the both side. So it's going to end up something like this. And the same thing is here. And again, this is the demonstration. Might be I want to do some simple design, but you can do it really complicated if you want. Next step, we need to have all those things cut out. So I'm going to use the trim tool, and I want to select everybody, so it's easier. So what we wanted to do is cut out those area. So to make sure that we have this individual closed curve, right, something like this. And it might be a little bit confused at the beginning, but it's okay. You pretty much is, I'll see, I make a mistake there. It's going to Control Z. Actually, I will need to keep that there. So this one, this one, this one. And bear with me, I'll show you just in a minute for what I'm doing here. So clean off this one. All right, so now if I delete all the extra that I don't need, for example, this one, those, I actually don't need the middle one as well. Don't need this one. And you kind of see what I'm doing here is try to creating a closed curve. So that one I didn't trim it. So now I have this one. Okay. Oh, I didn't trim those two. See, it's a little bit confused for all the line together, but that's fine. All right, so now we have this. Let's go ahead to join. All right, now I will suggest you to do is those sharp edges right there, sharp corner, not edges, sharp corner will somehow, once it turning into, we're gonna, you know, modify a little bit, all those sharp corner will be the problem for casting. So the easier way to do is we have this command called fillet corner, and let's try one. This one is the corner we want to fillet, and let's say fillet is 0.5 to make it nice and round on all of them. So this one, this one, this one, we want to actually fillet the corner like this. Okay. Now what we need to do is we need to flow all of things back to there. So I'm going to make this one into a surface. Okay, and it's a little bit hard to see. Let me make them into the black color or red color, so easier to see. Okay, so I have this line there, and we are going to use a command. It's called under the transform. You have flow along surface. Now I'm going to pick up all this curve right there, and I want to select one of the corner there, and then I will select one of the corner there. So you can see it's coming back to here. Okay, now let's take a look, detailed look on this one before we moving forward. You might already have a question. I can read your mind. You might thinking about why the outline is not aligned with my outline. If it is flowing back from that, it should be flowing back exactly. Why is shrinking? Very good questions. The reason it is shrinking is because when we have this surface was cut out from a bigger surface. Remember that we used the loft to create that. So this surface is actually the bigger one. The surface, like the big rectangular, is actually the bigger surface before we cut it. All right. So in that case, it is reading like the distance in between this 2 point, this point and this point, is the distance between here and the edge. Okay, so it's not flow accurately there. All right, so what we actually need to do, and I'm intentionally to show you this because I know this one, some of you might have a question like that, so I'll just go ahead to show you my little trick here. So the proper way to do it more accurately, to align more accurately, you should do this way. Before you creating the UV curve, it's a very important command. It's called shrink trim surface. All right, when you click on that, it feels like it's nothing happened, but actually it has something happened behind the stage. Okay, and then for comparison, I'm going to leave that there, but let's go to the curve. We do exactly the same thing, create UV curve, and then all of a sudden you kind of notice my shape is actually very close to the form, the boulder there. All right, so for quick comparison, I'm just gonna do something like this. I'm going to move it there, so that way we don't spend time to do the same thing and then you might feel bored. All right, so here, okay, we are going to do exactly the same thing. Let's make this into the surface. Okay, and we're gonna go to the transform, flow along the surface. So now you see this is much closer to what our original setting for 1.2 millimeter distance right there. So what we have now is we are going to pick up all the curve that we have, and we're just gonna go ahead to trim this area out. All right, you can also directly design on it if you like it, but that's one of way to lay out your design, and it's kind of stretch a lot, but that's one of way to do it. If you like it, you can actually go ahead and draw directly on it, that will work too. I just want to show you the different things. All right, so once you have this, all we need to do to create a thickness is by creating offset the surface. Okay, the surface that we have, I don't need it to be really thick, so let's say 0.75 millimeter, and we want to make sure solid equal yes. So I will have this thicknesses right there. Once you have done that, you can also tweak it a little bit more by twist. That will give it a little bit more definition. So let's say I want to twist from this point to that point, and kind of giving a little bit, you know, high and low kind of twist there. Okay, so now let's bring it back to our stone. All right, And this guy, now we can move it around a little bit more like this way. Okay. The very simple one is by using, let me delete those. So let's do polar array. We will pick up our object. We hit enter. Center will be 0. Number, let's try 12 of them. And then 360 degree. So then we will have this. And because it's overlapping, so you can create a lot of up and down. You might need to adjust a little bit. Some of them is like floating on the top, it's no support. That might be weaken your structure, but for this demonstration, I just want to show you what kind of command that you can use. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please let me know how your piece turned out. Leave a comment below. I really love to see everybody's interaction. That make me feel like what I'm doing is really meaningful to help other people. So please leave a comment. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next Monday.